Thank you so much. Let's do this. If you have your Bibles, and I want you to just go with me right quick. This won't take a long time. Who needs a word today, by the way? I want to again welcome in the thousands that are watching across the world to Cleveland, Ohio. And we're just 2 weeks before resurrection. I'm excited about it. Amen. We're still officially, according to the liturgical calendar, in the season of Lent, which is the special time. And I know they said it already. I don't care if you're watching me. I want everybody who believes, well, I'll talk about that. I'll talk about that in my sermon. But if you have your Bibles, get Matthew 25, verse 5. Matthew 25, verse 5. Again, to all of our guests, we would love to meet you and hug you after service. Matthew 25, verse 5. Since the groom was late, all the bridesmaids became drowsy and fell asleep. I'm gonna try it one more time. That's all I wanna read. Look at me, look at me now, look at me. Since the groom was late, all the bridesmaids became drowsy and fell asleep. Do me a favor, on the way to your seat, push five people and tell them, don't sleep on me. Go ahead, tell them. That's the wrong person. There's nothing on my screens, by the way. Amen. Don't sleep on me. Let me check my time. I want to make sure that I'm perfect. I won't be long today. Let me see. Okay, we good. I got 30 minutes. Then I want y'all to start booing me. Amen. Amen. It was Dr. King who said that one of the great liabilities of history is that too many people fall asleep during periods of great social transition. Every society, he said, has its protectors of the status quo and fraternities of indifference that are notorious for sleeping during revolution. He said, but the great task of society is no matter what, to stay woke, unquote. And speaking of staying woke, there are too many people, particularly post-pandemic, that have fallen asleep. And not so much a literal sleep, but rather a spiritual sleep. Watch this, sleep in apathy, sleep in indifference. I don't have to go anymore. I can just watch him on the phone, even though I'm not sick and I have gas in the car. I don't have to go to prayer anymore because prayer is like for the old people, right? Yeah, I don't really need God on that level because my business is prospering. And during the pandemic, we figured out we can get paid from the house. So my girl and I work from home, don't even really have to leave. And so church and God, things are just kind of flowing to me. And I think I'm just going to chill right now. The enemy is trying to get you to relax in apathy. He's trying to get you to relax in spiritual indifference. Yes, the enemy wants you to fall asleep. And speaking of sleep, this particular text, I love it because most of you grew up hearing some preacher, watch this, preach about the 10 virgins. You ready to fall out your seat? I really never preached about the 10 virgins. My girl did one time, did a cold-blooded job. I told her one day, I'm going to steal that sermon from you. But I've never really dealt with these 10 virgins. Most of you grew up on the 5 virgins who had the oil and the 5 that did not. To me, I think it's powerful because of interpretive significance or something that requires, stick with me, I'm coming, something that requires real interpretive discourse is this. One must understand when reading this, because the text opens by saying, I want you to look at it. The Bible says God's kingdom, verse 1, look at it, is like 10 virgins who took oil lamps and went out to greet the bridegroom. Smart class, by the way. Normally during a wedding, we call the lady the what? And we call the guy she's getting ready to marry the what? But that's something because here, Hebraically, and in Hebrew Bible, he's the bridegroom. Okay, you wouldn't say that, would you? You say he's the groom, but Bible language, he's the bridegroom. He is the fella that proposed to the girl. Now, engagement different then than engagement now. Because when you got engaged then, if you broke it off, you had to get divorced from your engagement. That's to all of you that's been engaged like 16 times. Come on, all of us got that friend. Never quite gets to the altar, but got seven rings. Praise God. Amen. Right? So there's the bridegroom. So here's what would happen in Hebrew culture. Great class, by the way. What happened in Hebrew culture was you propose to the girl. And then once you proposed to the girl, her father said yes. Sometime you had to pay a dowry for her virginity. Lean on some woman and say, how much you cost? Praise God, amen. Oh, Lord, I didn't lost her. Amen. Okay, I shouldn't have did that. That was unfair, praise God, no. But you had to pay a dowry for her virginity. Watch this. She'd say yes. The arrangements would be made. Watch this. Then you went back to your house and she stayed with her daddy. Let me try this again. You went back to your house. I'm going to try this one more time, bros. How you getting married without a house? You went back to your, oh, I'm sorry. Praise God. Or you at least had some place for her to stay. Normally, you would be on your father's property. You have some sort of space for her to come to. Watch this. You didn't live with her. I know the world has changed. Bruh got to preach. Bruh got to preach. Not bruh got to preach. And normally, it was a bride and a groom. Not a bride and a... And it wasn't a groom and a... Okay, so I'm just giving you Bible. There's a man and a woman. Never thought I'd have to say this on Sunday morning. I promise. In my soul, I never thought I'd have to define marriage on a Sunday morning. I promise you. Even 10 years ago, you wouldn't have paid me to believe that I would have to get up and tell young people, now, you know, marriage should be like a bride and a groom, and really have to say that with my mouth. And then I never thought I'd have to explain that, no, you're not supposed to live with her until you marry her. Now, that's like marriage teaching 101. So on the day of the wedding, the bruh would come marching down the street with his family and his crew and his groomsmen, a big old parade, watch this, going to get his bride. He'd march from his house down the street. This was a big day. The city knew about it. It was a parade. It was almost a festival because marriage matters. She still had her virginity intact. He's never made love to her. He didn't stay with her. The father has blessed it. This is major. He's on his way. So all of that to say, because whatever else this text deserves, it is some criticism. When we say criticism, there is what? Redaction criticism, narrative criticism, social science criticism, but in this case, cultural criticism. In other words, how do you criticize the text to make sure people get clarity? That's all that means, future seminary students. So this cultural criticism is this. That culture of marriage was different than ours. Yes, so there's these 10 versions, watch this, as it were, 10 bridesmaids. Now you'll understand what verse 2 means because it says five of them were foolish and five of them were wise. Five of them were morose and five of them were phoneru. Okay, wait a minute. Five of them were morose. Okay, in the Greek text, am I boring you? Then wave at me and say, keep on teaching. Unless you want me to hoop. Well, let me teach them. Because my mother-in-law said, yes, please hoop. Old school, I love it. Watch this, because I want y'all to catch this. It is the idea that in the Greek, morose means stupid. It means blockhead, Kevin. It means silly. That's why the next verse says, in another version, five of them were silly and five of them were smart. If I tried to make this up, I couldn't. So we do a photo shoot yesterday. All pastors know this. Post-pandemic, the game has changed. Everything's YouTube and social media. So there's so many pictures of you. They need a picture every Sunday, a picture for every Bible cast I do. So you used to do like one photo shoot a year. That would hold you to the very next year. All pastors know what I'm talking about. Now we got to do one quarterly. So all the time, my girl and I are doing photo shoots. So yesterday, we had to do another one at the house. And she's like, listen, put on some mood music. So we can get, you know. You know, all that, so. So we flipping through the channels. I couldn't make this up. I just get through studying. I come across 40 and over, Denise Williams, Silly of Me. Yeah. Millennials is called YouTube. Praise God. Amen. But many of you know this, Silly of Me, to think that I could ever. Okay, stop. This is Sunday morning, and we have a lot of guests here. That's what they heard about this church, that it's not really a church and all that. And then she said, oh, love, oh, love, stop making the fool. You ready? You ready? She said, stop making a fool. Because morose literally means foolish. That's why the King James says what? Five foolish women, five of them were foolish, five of them were smart. It's not me calling them stupid, the Greek does. The Greek, it means morose, stupid. It means silly. It means blockhead. Literally, five of them were just blockheads. Five of them were wise phroneros, which means sagacious. It is the idea they can be trusted, secretive, wise. This is so cold-blooded. So five of them, this is so much. So I'm running through this. We hear Silly in Me, and I thought to myself, I told my girl, some stuff you can't make up. I'm trying to get ready for my sermon, and it talks about silly women, and then Silly in Me comes on. And all of a sudden, because Shakespeare said there are sermons and stones, Silly of Me jumped in my mind, silly of me to think that I could ever get by. Watch this, silly of me to have babies before I had a plan. Yes, silly of me to fall in love with a girl that was good in the bed but no good for my head. Silly of me to put the enemy in front of my Jesus. Silly of me to make moves with my money. Watch this, because I let my loins lead my logic. I'm preaching to 10 people. Let me try it again. Thank you, Dr. Eric Michael Dyson. I let my loins lead my logic, so babies came before I was prepared to be a daddy. Babies came before I was prepared to be a mother. All of us, because I started to jump on these women, then it hit me, all of us have been silly. Okay, I'm sorry. Maybe not 10 of you, but to the rest of us, do you remember a silly moment? I'm sorry. A stupid moment? Okay, let me talk about me, since you all of that. I've done some stupid stuff. Watch this. Since I've been saved. Now, you want to know why I shout at church? Because God is saving me from my stupid. He is saving me from my silly. Can I get some former silly women that would thank God that you don't have to seem silly of me no more, because now you're walking in wisdom and you don't settle for dummies. You don't settle for stupid stuff. You make better decisions. Hit three people, say, silly of me, silly of me. That was... The next verse is on the screens because it's going to bless your life, because the Bible says, since the groom was late, all the bridesmaids became drowsy and fell asleep. Okay, so in a very real sense, this is important. This is no indictment on physical sleep. There's nothing deep about that. I could try to lift some crazy, beautiful point. They fell asleep. Why would they fall asleep? Because he's running late. They're tired. They just happen to fall asleep. It's not so much that sleep, watch this, is wrong. It is going to sleep unprepared. Ooh, I feel like preaching to somebody. The Bible says they're waiting on this thing to start. So maybe, of course, these are her bridesmaids, and so they're waiting. Normally, as you are coming, because sometimes this would happen at night, you're gonna love this, in preparation for the next day, you'll love this, everybody had their own torch, and their torch was lit. This is just a lot of historical, cultural stuff you won't see in the text. Just a lot of deep studying and exegeting to get this, but I have to get behind the text. Because, and you knew someone was a wedding crasher if they didn't have a torch. Because they just bum rushed, got in the crowd, and they're like, where your light? No, bro, you're not even in this parade. Hence the reason for lamp and oil. Right? You've been hearing this all your life, right? Let's dig behind this familiar pericope, because I want you to catch this. They all have oil Elder Lampley, they all have oil. Five of them don't have none. Okay, so the next verse says, this is going to bless your life. I want you to catch this. Because the next verse says, at midnight, someone shouted, the groom is here. Come meet him. Woo! The groom is here. All of a sudden, once they fell asleep, a groom shows up. Somebody shout, he here! He here, y'all! He here, y'all! So they jump up. Next verse says, all the bridesmaids were woke and got their lamps ready. Then all the bridesmaids woke up and got their lamps ready. Look at the next verse. I'm going fast today because the silly version said to the smart ones, our lamps are going out. Lend us some of your oil. I feel like preaching. Okay, you've been knowing this all your life, but let's tear this church up. I only have 15 minutes. The ones went to sleep with no oil. The other ones were sleeping in peace. Because I got my oil. And 10 of you are shouting because you understand that scripturally, oil is a type of the Holy Ghost. I didn't get nobody to have church with me. So 10 of them were spirit-filled, as it were, spirit-led. Watch this, ready for whatever come. Because when I'm spirit-filled and Jesus connected, when storms hit my life, and if I could drop this on you, if I could put some eschatology in my theology, from an eschatological perspective, interpretive discourse demands that I tell you that scholars go back and forth on who the bridegroom is. Well, they don't go back and forth on who he is. He's Jesus. What they go back and forth on is, which coming is this? Is this the rapture where he comes back for the church and he does not touch the ground, but we go up? Or is this the millennial reign coming where we come back with him? Okay, we come back with him. He puts one foot. Y'all gonna have church with me? They don't know which one it is. Now, in the millennial reign, we come with him. We got on all white. This is for the fight. But here's the good thing. We don't have to throw no punches. I'm from down the way. Remember, if you had a friend that could fight, all you had to do was do like this. Y'all just missed that prayer. Y'all just missed it. I wished I had 10 people. Because when he comes back this time, he's coming back with a sword in his hand. Y'all better have church with me. But that's for free. So this passage is really a kind of eschatological statement that says, be ready when he comes. But that's not the best part. He says, give us some of your oil. Let's just have church for about 18 more minutes. I wished I had somebody that would look at your neighbor with no shame in your game. Lean on somebody, say, I got my own oil. Go ahead, praise God. Oh, I wished I had 15 people that may not have a man in your bed yet. Maybe you don't have $1 million yet, but can I get somebody that would thank God that you have the oil of the Holy Spirit and you don't need nobody else's oil? They can keep their money and keep their man and keep their house. I'm sorry, hit five people, say, I got my oil, go ahead. This is so funny. Because they say, since they didn't prepare, give me some of your oil. When they could have got their oil themselves. All people come here. Those watching me across the world, I'm going to argue nobody's ever thought of this in your life. And this might make somebody fall out your seat. I did a Bible cast, and shameless plug, make sure you watch Daddy Pain. If you caused it, or if you are the recipient of it, you got to watch Daddy Pain. It's going to bless your life. I promise you. I talk about what causes daddy pain, how to get over it, work through it. God gave me real revelation. One of the things I said about a real daddy, I said a real daddy, and I meant it, a real daddy will show up if you call and say, I think I just hurt somebody. Police on the way. I didn't do it on purpose, daddy. A real daddy is saying, stay right there. I'm coming. I'm gonna put your sweater on with the blood on it. You get in my car and go home. And I'll do these 30 for you with a smile on my face. Y'all just missed that. You didn't hear what I just said. Okay, I'm gonna try that again. A real father. And some of you are like, I don't know about me, because then, bro, you're not me. You, please, I'm going to jail smiling. locked up. No. And maybe that's wrong, but I still mean it. Yeah, I'm going to get. So something hit me this morning that I never thought of. I said, I would gladly give my life today for any of my 5 children with a smile on my face. But I never thought about this until today. But I'm not sure I'd give up my soul. Let me try this again. I never thought about it. I'm not sure they could have my Holy Ghost because they didn't want him for themselves. I'm not sure they could have my salvation because they refused to choose Jesus when they can. I give up my life. I can't give up my eternal life. I feel like if they want eternal life, they're going to have to. Sometimes all it takes is a little effort and one choice. Did I tell y'all sermons were in stones? So this morning, I couldn't make this up. Y'all pray for my dog. He has a good heart, but he's not the brightest by a long shot. Marley needs prayer. He likes little puppies that's too young. He's not the smartest, and he likes to sleep with both genders. So he got a lot going on. Yeah, he'll hump anything and anybody at any time. So just pray for Marley. Just not the brightest. But we love him, and we don't know. Praise God. Amen. I let him out this morning, and he wanted to come back in. I left the door. Well, you know what? Just show him this. Cut it up loud, please, everybody.
Come on. Come on. Marley, the door is open. Come on, just push your way through. Come on. Come on, buddy. It's open. Marley, the door is open. Come on. Come on, buddy. Come on. Come on, man. Something could happen. You may have to bust in here and help me. Come on. Marley. Come on, buddy. Come on, buddy. Marley, the door is open. Come on. You rather stand there? Come on. My question to all of you. How much does God have to open the door for you to push your way through?
Hear 3 people say, the door is open. Go ahead. He said, I hate to tell y'all, I left him out there for an hour because I was determined to know, would you freeze to death before you push your way in? The door is cracked. If he just would have nudged it a little bit, but he's so used to people opening the door for him that he didn't want to use a little strength. And God said, this is the season for you to bust that door open. I wish I had some people here. In 2023, hit somebody and say, I'm kicking that door in, praise God. I've been broke too long. I've been sick too long. I've been struggling too long. I've been depressed too long. I've been in my feelings too long. I've been suffering from parent pain too long. This is my season to kick the door. I'm sorry. Go Bruce Lee. Everybody's out. Oh, I'm out of here. I only got 5 minutes. Can I tell y'all something? The Bible says that when the bridegroom arrived, they jumped up, and now they have a shortage. I've been telling those who go to this church for 10, 15, 20 years, the worst time to call on God is when you need him. None of you can stand that cuz, and they only call when they. But if you have relationship with me, if you've proven your connection to me, and then you fall short, and I love you, and I got it. Most people here got two kinds of family members and friends. I'm trying to be neither. Watch this. I love you, but I ain't got it. Or they got it, but they don't love you. Can I prophesy over 200 people that you're gonna be the person in the family that has the love and the resources? So when somebody calls, you say, I got it. How fast can you get here? I wish I had 10 people. You know, Uncle would if he could. No, Uncle can you get to me, or I'll cash app you. As long as you living right and trying, I'm trying to get the blessing to you. You're my nephew, you're my sister, you're my friend. If I got it, I'm losing myself here. Here's what I want to tell you. They get up. They get up now, and the wise women say, no, we cool on that. Can't have none of our oil. Be careful not to give so much of yourself away. You don't have nothing left. God, I'm preaching. I don't know. Some of you, you didn't gave him so much, there's none of you left. So you look spacey when I see you. Yeah, you didn't put up with so much, you're just walking around in a daze. Yeah, my girl and I look at certain members. We say, remember she used to be just bubbly, now she'd just be like he just took everything out of her. Yeah, she'll tell you. We say, man, remember she used to be so cute, now she'd just be, hey, Pastor. Hey, Lady Vernon, just gone. Like he stripped her. Or like life, don't wait until there's that kind of deficit. Yeah, sometimes you giving children so much, your life gone. And they grown. So they bouncing in and out and money and stuff and life, and you got their kids and helping them while they do nothing, and now you losing you. And you didn't get your all away, because now you don't even feel the power of God or veracity or energy. You gotta stay, everybody here, here's my big lesson. Who knew this had pneumatological nuance? I'm in my seat, I gotta promote people. Pneumatology, systematic theology, branch of systematic theology is pneuma, spirit. Pneumatology, study of the Holy Spirit. Who knew that the five foolish and the five wise versions was really a teaching on Holy Spirit? Who knew that? Because oil represents the kind of Holy Spirit. Okay, I'm done. I thought I could do better. I got to stop. I got 3 minutes. Let me borrow two, because I want to tell y'all this. I'm coming home the other day. This is the truth, everybody. I couldn't make it up. I'm coming home the other day and got this new truck. My new truck, I had the old Range and finally the new one. And so I'm in it. And so I've had it for years. Many of you know I drove it for 10, 11 years. And finally, you know, something happened to it. Long story. Praise God. So I had... I had to get me another one. And so I'm driving and I'm on the phone with Lady Vernon, like, yeah, baby, I love you. I'm on my way. I'm about 5 minutes away. I'm coming now. And then I got quiet. She says, what's wrong? I said, she says, what's wrong? Why did you pause? I said, baby, my truck just said something I've never seen. I said, I've never seen it. It said, please fill up. I'm gonna try this again. Now I got a team of guys for 20 years. They won't let my wife and I gas up. When we pull up, they pull out. At the house, my assistant, all that, they keep everything full, because 3 o'clock in the morning, somebody could die. I gotta be gone. I ain't got time to stop at the gas station. So this is not being grand, this is my job. So I got good people who gas up for me and her. I never had to think about it. Some type of way, things got mixed up and nobody gassed up. I haven't pumped gas in this new truck one time since I had it. I've never thought about gas. I don't think about gas. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. I'm serious. I'm just sitting here now thinking, everybody can't say that. That's a blessing, and I don't want to take them for granted. Can y'all clap for them? I mean that. I never thought about it. I don't think about gas. So I had an older Range. I've been driving since I was 18. I've seen low fuel. I've seen orange light pop on. I've never seen a car get emotional. My Range Rover said, please Okay, y'all got to catch this. I got to go. I got to go. I'm only 3 minutes from the house. If you've been to my house, you know the gas station right there at the freeway. I'm pulling past that. I'm like, you know what? If I get to the house, my guy, he'll take care of that. Just get to the house. But then something hit me. The car said, please. Which was telling me, if you're not careful, you might not make it home. I wish I had 10 people. I hear God saying to 20 people, please fill up again. Please refill. Because you don't know what's coming. You don't know who might die. You don't know who might cheat on you. You don't know who might leave you. You don't know what might happen. Please. Hit five people, say, fill up again. Go ahead. I got to get out of here. I got to get out of here. The Bible says, and I bid you goodbye. The Bible says when they got back, they tried to get in, but the party had already started. They tried to get into the party, to the festival, to the reception. Party had already started. Matter of fact, your Bible says, can I come in? Verse 12 says, but he answered, I don't even know who you are. I don't even know who you are, and you think you're about to come in. Don't you leave here without Jesus knowing your name. Don't you walk out of here without a pure relationship. Can you imagine the trumpet sounds and you walk up to Jesus and he says, I don't know you, but I was next to pastor on Sunday. Yeah, you was next to pastor, not me. God, and then finally, this is all I got for you. Verse 13, I'm cutting it all off. So stay awake because you don't know the day nor the hour. I'm out of here. Y'all just give me 2 minutes. I said 30. I need 35. Let me give you three reasons to stay woke and what you should stay woke in. Let's just have a little church and then let's elevate some people who deserve it. Number one, you'll love this. Stay woke with priorities. Stay woke with priorities. Y'all missed that. Stay woke with priorities. If this is the year of focus, stay woke. Don't slip. You and your girl decided something. My wife knows, and all husbands, watch this. When I put my mind to something, it's done. Unless God stops it. If I put my mind to something, she's sitting to my right, I can't lie, it's done. Yeah, rather be school, anything I say, baby, this is it. She can trust it unless God stops it. Because he's bigger than me. So it hit me, only bill I got left is my ranch. And I decided in the name of Jesus, by the end of this year, I want it done. Y'all just missed that. So that when I stand up, I can be an absolute free black man. And the reason why I got to pay everything off is because they might arrest me soon. Because I'm not going to stop preaching. And I'm not going to preach what they want me to preach. And I'm going to say what I need to say. So I got to make sure she got some money and a place to stay, because I don't know what's going to happen. I really mean that. This is the season for the prophets to be free. The reason why the system wants to lock you up is so you have to kiss their behind. But I speak over the life of this ministry, all your bills paid, and that you don't make any more bills, so you don't have to kiss your bosses behind or the systems behind. And so she asked me about our vacation. I said, my kids need to see that I'll do a little something, but not what we normally do. It won't be the boss when I normally take, and I can afford to, but I decide to let them see me model that. How good will we vacate when I don't owe nobody? How prophetic will I be when I don't owe a cent to nobody? I don't know who this word is for, but I'm supposed to speak this over some young couple's life, that it may take 5-10 years, depending on where you are now, but I speak over your life complete freedom. Romans 13 verse 8 says, owe no man anything. The Bible says, whoever the Son sets free is free indeed. Not just salvifically, but I speak you free in every area of your life. I gotta go. And so stay woke in priorities. Decide what you're gonna do. So I told her, don't throw nothing up that we don't absolutely need, because I want to model this for my babies. They know daddy can afford to go, but I want them to see me not go, so they can see me burn a mortgage and invite the whole family and see that we are free. Y'all better check. But then secondly, stay woke with prayer. Now this Wednesday at 7 p.m., we gonna pray. Prayer is not as sexy as a free concert, but it is for me. And when we prayed this Wednesday, I told my girl, I'm not even sure I want everybody, because everybody won't mean it. It might change the anointing, but to those of you who believe in the power of prayer, I invite you to be here between Wednesday between 6:30 and 8, and set this place on fire, because prayer will keep you when nothing else does. So stay woke in priorities. Number two, stay woke in prayer. And then goodbye, stay woke in praise. I gotta go. But can I get 50 real people on a Sunday morning that will praise God with everything you got? Not just because of what you have, but because of what he's done in your life. If the Lord has opened doors for you that no man can close, if your child is breathing, if you got 10 fingers and 10 toes, let everything, if God woke you up this morning, closed in your right mind, then slap your neighbor high five and say, neighbor, I got to praise him. He's been better to me than I've been to myself. If you're not too mean, shake your neighbor's hand. I said, shake your neighbor. I'm gonna try this one more time for the people that, I said, shake your neighbor's hand. Now shake them and rock them. Rock them and shake them. Shake them and rock them. Rock them and shake them. And say, neighbor, I got a reason to praise him. Can I give you 5 reasons that I gotta praise him? Reason number one, he woke me up this morning. Reason number two, he woke me up this morning. Reason number three, he woke me up this morning. Reason number four, he woke me up this morning. Reason number five, he woke me up this morning. If he woke you up, I dare you to sit there quietly, but open up your mouth and tell your section, he woke us up this morning. Yes. And good evening, Word Church. I got to close. Push 5 people and tell them, don't sleep on me. Don't get confused. 2023, I'm coming in. 2023, I'll be better. I said, push your neighbor. Tell them, don't sleep on me. It's not over for me. God is not through with me yet. But when I come forth, I shall come forth like pure gold. Can I get 50 people to open up your mouth for one more minute and praise him like he's keeping you warm? Get in the nearest aisle and praise him. said. The spirit is subject to the prophet. Any pastor tells you he can't stop, he lying. She can't stop. The spirit is subject to the prophet. So we can shout all day, but I don't want to take all the fire from the moment I came for. Come on, let me hear you. Come on, guys. Put the keyboard in my thing. I want to hear him. Let me say this to you. This is so good. I want to say this, and we're going to do this as expeditiously as possible. And sit for a minute, because this will take a moment. But whenever you feel led to jump back up, do it. Because I'm sure somebody here means something to you. Lady Vernon is an avid, Dr. Vernon, my wife, is an avid Bible reader and studier. Every morning, without exception, very few exceptions, does she not join me in our morning meditation? And we read at different times. I don't care what time she read. I tell couples, we try to do one thing together every week. I don't care when she reads, just read. I wouldn't want a woman that don't read the Bible. Yeah, I don't know what she might do. Yeah. Same thing with my husband. So she's in Deuteronomy 1 the other day and calls me in the car where God is speaking to Moses about this transference of authority. And God says, I need you to pick some serious, trustworthy men. For the sake of this context, I would say people who can help you lead. And God just drops that in her morning devotion, 1 year Bible, on the week that I'm elevating people. I said, come on, Jesus. So I started to change my whole sermon, I did, and preach Deuteronomy 1. And then God said, no, it's Jesus time. So I pray you've been enjoying this series titled A Man Named Jesus. But the other day, last week, I'm up in prayer. God jumps me up, and says, stop thinking church and think kingdom. Church says you elevate people at the end of the year, after Christmas, before Thanksgiving, whatever. The year is gone. And the Lord said there's a leadership void at the word. So many wonderful elders that I would kiss the rest of their life gave me so much wonderful service. Just life happened. Some walked away, fell away, ran away, went away the right way. That's okay. Post-pandemic, all that. And it hit me, there's not enough leaders at the top. And I don't want that much power. No, I need people to think with me. And we're a mega church, which means you need mega leadership. And so he started dropping these faces. Some of you, God speaks to you like that. I started seeing people's faces that I wasn't thinking about. I said, come on, Holy Ghost. Coupled with that, the elders that we had already put up as elder elects. Come on, baby. Come on, join me right quick. And something just sort of hit me that it's time to promote them. And God said, don't wait. Do it now. Would y'all clap? And so I ran the names by my girl, and then I called other elders to make sure that we were on the same page, and it just sort of hit us. And Steph, I think we'll have that camera up here, Steph, to go around this. But I want to do this, and you guys can control it when you're ready. But I want to do this. I want to call them. And as I call them, first, I want to call the elder elects. I want to give a story about all of them that takes about a minute. I'm going to beg you not to walk, because on top of all of that, matter of fact, I'm so sorry. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Before I do that, would you just pray right now? There may be somebody who needs Jesus. Lord, forgive me. And we'll put it up on the screen, because when I start flowing, I don't know what's going to happen. If I was preaching and you were thinking to yourself, I'm the person he's talking to. I didn't ran out. I didn't run out of joy. I didn't run out. I'm a Christian, but I don't feel Holy Spirit like that. Or if you want to get saved today, if you want to join our church or join Jesus online, there's a number you can text right there. If you're in this house, I'm going to beg you now, just like my dog, look at me, looking through the door. I can't make you come in. But when I get through with all of this, you still can walk up to us and say, I want to join the church today because I might not make it home. Like pastor was scared he might not make it home. I might not make it home. And so if you're unsaved, unchurched today, I really mean this. If you want to join our church, if you fell away, some of you, you came back for something today and you're thinking, I ain't getting no preaching like this where I'm at. Or I'm not getting no worship like this. I miss it here at the Word. I tell people, put your pride aside and come home. Yeah, when people say they're leaving, I say, I bless you as you go. And if you get over there and it's not what you think, come on back. You leave right, you can come back. And even if you leave wrong, you can come back. Amen. So if you want to come back to our church, if you feel like this is where I need to be, this is where God speaks to me, we offer Christ to you today. So keep that in mind that you would do that as we go. So real quickly, I'm going to call their names. First of all, there were some elder elects that we put on, and we're going to ask for them to come today. And as I call their name, first of all, this girl, this beautiful woman does not make a lot of noise, but she served me quietly. Average person, may not know her, but she served downtown, any place I've had a campus, and I just absolutely love her. Would you receive Elder Myra Phillip Barnes? Come on, y'all clap better than that. Come on, clap for her. Praise God. Praise God. I love you. I love you. I love you. She is now, watch this, Elder Myra. Say Elder Myra. Say it out loud, Elder Myra. Now, whatever I tell you to call them, because some of them will call by their last name. Some of them got the same last name as their husband, which is a good thing. So we'll call them by their first name. So whatever I tell you to call them, that's what you call them from now on. This is Elder Myra. This lady, I don't have to say nothing about. Her husband is not an elder. There are three kinds of spouses. I need to drop this on you now. There is a spouse that is an elder with you because both of y'all love it. Both of y'all called to it. And it just makes sense. There is the spouse that says, no, I'm not an elder, but pastor, I bless him as he does it. I bless her, watch this, and I'm not going to embarrass them. And I'm not going to complain as they serve. Then there's a third category. We like everything about you, but she too toxic for us to promote you. Yeah, he's not ready. He'll be jealous of you and mad at you. So even though you ready, he going to fight you. So we got to hold you up. Anybody you see up here, either their spouse is with them or their spouse has blessed them. Would y'all clap for that? Amen. This young lady is the latter. Her husband is not one, but he's my dude. Who in the world can hate on Elder Connie Jones? Where you at, Connie? Praise God. Yeah. Oh, come on, y'all clap. You will call her. You will call her Elder Connie. Say, hey, Elder Connie. This gentleman is in the back with me every Sunday. It's like 10 people in this world that I would give all my money to. I could tell you a story, which is true. One day there was some stuff with my transfers and stuff. I needed some money right quick. I don't keep a bunch in the bank. I keep it where you need to keep it, where it's making money. I needed some cash to do something. He came up with a suitcase. He looked like the mafia. I mean, he like a straight gangster. I was scared to open it. We counting it like dope men, like praise God, amen. That's how much I trust him. I would trust him with my children. I would, to watch my children and to hold all my money while I went out of town. Can't say that about everybody. Would you just go crazy for Elder Sam Sparks? Come on, everybody. Y'all clap. I love you. Real quick, this brother has been serving. We all love him. When there was a void, who knew all this was in him with his quiet behind? And now he is helping hundreds of people musically and spiritually. It's time to come up. Elder George Granville III.
Thank you.
I'm so happy you will call him Elder George. Say, hey, Elder George. This brother is my, well, everybody knows it. He makes me look handsome on Sunday. Well, handsomeness can happen. Praise God. It's hard to make me handsome, but come on, we all love him. We call him, who knew this? The Bible says that David would worship until his clothes came off. I'll say it out loud. Name me another man in this church that dances when he worships. Like Elder Dave Gully. Come on, everybody. Come on, everybody. Yes, he is also my barber and all that. I just love him to death. So would you clap for the elder elects, everybody? Y'all come a little closer. Come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Right there. Praise God. All right. These are the ones I didn't see coming, but I'm going with God. Please don't walk. I am so happy. He lost his son last year. Yes, his son passed away. I absolutely fell in love with him. As he walked through that, he never stopped coming. He never stopped worshiping. Elder Howard, as you know, was a former pastor in this city, and he was Elder Howard's number one when he was a pastor. When Elder Howard came here, Elder Howard, like John the Baptist, told him, hear ye him now. And from that day to now, he's been serving me, and his name came up, and we like him a lot. He's single, but leave him alone. Praise God. Amen. If he like you, he'll come up to you. Plus, I think he got some little girl he like around him. I'm going to figure it out, though. Amen. Amen. Dating is fine if you're single. He's doing everything the right way. We like him. Elder Reginald Hamilton Sr. Come on, y'all. Come on, y'all. Y'all got to clap better than that. I love him. I love him. I love him. We will call him Elder Reggie. Say, hey, Elder Reggie. This woman of God, I saw her as a baby before she started having babies. Her and my dear son. Listen, I don't even call myself the model of how to have family. We're blended. I wouldn't change a thing, but I want young people to do it a certain way. And these two did it the right way in every way in terms of waiting, all that, both educated, master's degrees, 2.5 children, dog and a white fence. Amen. They just did it all right. Her husband is popular and one of our best preachers. Holy Spirit told me it was time for her to join him. Elder Jonia Patton, everybody. Come on. I got another one. She has been with me for 20 something years. I absolutely love her. She's been faithful, worked as an usher, greeter, anything I've needed. One of them girls that have cut somebody over me and Lady Vernon. Watched her come here, just a little girl, and figuring out her way. Now she is on fire, married to one of our best elders, Atimus Carter Howard. Come on, y'all. Come on, y'all. I'm so proud. I could tell you this story all day. If you know her, you know how shy she is. She has been in Word Everything Store for 20 years, helping me, just as pretty as she could be, in love with Jesus. I raised her in the Lord. She found her husband here, everything. And the Lord told me, her, we've been back and forth. First, she was shy and called me back and said, Holy Ghost wouldn't let me sleep. She said, Pastor, my daddy told me it's good to have a saved daddy. She called her daddy out of town. He said, you've been there 20 years. If not now, when? If you don't join your husband and serve, she called me back. I'm welcoming to eldership. Elder Monique Gully, everybody, come on. Y'all better come on. Come on, y'all clap. Y'all clap. Can I tell y'all this? Here's another one right quick. Got to give y'all this. who has served next to her husband. She's also my co-chair of our board of directors, trusted with my life, did her wedding to this day. Her and her husband are the only people that I've married that not only never made love before they got married, but never kissed. And God told her husband not to touch her at all. It was such an anointed wedding at Maple. She's been here 20 years. Would y'all welcome to eldership, Elder Rachel Coleman, everybody. Oh, come on, everybody. Oh, my baby, my baby. My baby. She just got promoted from being a principal. Now she's the principal's principal. And so come on, everybody. I don't have to say nothing else. This girl crazy was in LA witnessing gang. God changed her life. Everybody know her. She's got that dog in her. If you need it, she'll do it. Her husband has blessed this and I love him. Would you welcome Tiana Golson? I'm hurrying. Please don't walk because you got to see me lay hands on them. This is a historic day at the Word Church. We're still on good time. Here it is right quick. Okay, this brother came in here and in all transparency, yes, he is my nephew, but my God, my own children have fallen in love with him. The teens love him. Would you welcome Elder Terrence Wesley Carr the third? The second. Oh, he is anointed. And the teens have fallen in love with him. And I need some elders in their 30s so that when we go off the scene, they will be here. Here's a challenge. I couldn't think of six elders in their 30s that I thought could stand on this stage. Be here tomorrow night. That won't be true in 2 years. But I couldn't think of five, six elders in their 30s that I would bet my spirit on that they could handle this. I think we're going to... I needed to get younger. Him and George in their 30s, everybody. Y'all better clap for them. Amen. Come on, come on. Here we go. Okay, here's another one I got to give y'all. This is a very important one. I'm a try not to cry. I don't have to tell y'all. This was God. I start shouting. Because what do you do when you pastor for 20 years? Watch this. Overseas. And a pandemic comes and your church gets shut down. And you got to come back to America without thinking about doing that. What do you do when you've been the leading lady of a place for 20 years? And if you've already met her before you clap, you've already seen that it's contagious on the Williams girls. You can't meet them and not love them. Lady Vernon's maiden name is Williams, Daddy Williams, and her and Dolores' last name was Williams, Mother Williams. And so they were born, I say it out loud, to be first ladies. It's been put in their DNA. I don't even know 10 people who don't like them. People just like touching them anyway. But I say that to say, he came back, church shut down. He comes back, boom. I watched God restore, and boom, this cold-blooded job making just gions of money. Bought a beautiful house already. I said, man, take 2 years. Take a year and just grieve and work through it. Come when you want to. He was in the service 20 years in the Air Force in Okinawa, Japan. Retires from that. He was both pastor and in the service, then another almost 20, man, he's my hero. And can I tell you what the Lord said? I don't need to get to know you. You're my best friend in the world. Him and I said that our dream job, when we stop pastoring, our dream job, I promise you, is to be some guy's assistant because we know what he needs. And you don't know how much what we would do. You know, it's hard to think like a pastor. When he reached for something, you already put it in his hand. You can tell what he's thinking just by looking at it. And we said, let's not ever need each other because we're best friends. Let's not ever need each other financially. But here's what I love. He don't need this. He's doing this because he loved me. I said, there's one thing I'm going to ask of you humbly. I'm not bishop because I'm not bishop, even though I cover hundreds of pastors, because the streets call me Pastor Vernon. And I'm more interested in the streets than church people. I really mean that. So I said, if I'm not bishop, even if I were bishop, can't be two of that in the same. So I'm gonna need you to do one thing, change that title for me. And my brother said humbly, yes. Then his beautiful wife, who was Lady D for all these years, I said, it's only one first lady. We don't wanna confuse people. But my God, she said, forget first lady, just call me D. I don't have to be nothing, bruh. I love you, I wanna help you and my sister. I said, no, you deserve a title. 20 something years. Would you now welcome, because I said so, Elder Terry, Elder Carr, and Elder D. Would y'all clap? Come on, everybody. Come on, come on. Oh, I need y'all to clap. I need y'all to clap. Oh, y'all can do better than that. Are y'all happy for Pastor? This is like having LeBron James on your team. He can see what I see. I trust him with my life. He can help me train my elders. He's a pastor. So when you see him, you'll call him Elder Carr and her Elder D. Say, hey, Elder D. Say, hey, Elder Carr. I love it. Listen, I got two more, and then we're going to lay hands, and we're going to walk out to the convention center together. This one you're not going to see coming. But the Lord told me he is one of the fathers of this house, and we do not hold age against you. No, no. The worst you could do is hold old against somebody. It's a blessing to get old. And I want to speak that over this congregation. We were promoting people in their 60s and 70s. The Lord told me he's been with me since I started this church. He mentors men and young boys, even helps me with my sons, taking them to lunch and dinner. He's a man's man. Everybody loves him, been married to one woman over 50 years. Watch this. And then when he lost his daughter and all that, raised his grandson who's back there next to him, been raising kids and loving people. Word Church go crazy for Elder Curtis Campbell. Oh, y'all gotta do better than that. Come on. I need y'all to clap. I need y'all to clap. Oh, y'all can clap better than that, long as he's been here. Oh, don't start crying. You're gonna make me cry. Lord Jesus, one of my best. And dealing with cancer for the last 18 years, but cancer can't kill him. Would y'all just stretch your hand and say, healed, 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 healed. This last one, I'm saving for last on purpose. Shh. Don't none of y'all see it coming. It didn't even happen till about Thursday. And I jumped up and said, girl, I'm gonna throw a name at you. You're gonna fall out the bed. And I said, before you tell me why not and think about it. I said, ain't no woman up there no better than her. They all beautiful, but because there's no husband and been through some stuff, I said, who kisses more people on Sunday? Who's at every service we have? Who's always putting money in our hand, knowing we don't need it when she need it, and she make us take it and say, I need a blessing. I called her. And said, what I'm about to say not going to make sense, but God said, you're it. I said, you represent the girl who did not dot every I, which is all of them, and my wife and all of you, but for sure had some children, maybe not the husband, but when God got a hold of your life, you've made some mistakes. But what about the girl in our church that needs to see somebody look like her? We used to call her Kizzy. But today, her name, she changed it. And here's the best name on the stage, Elder Beloved. Woo, bless his name. Woo, Jesus. Woo. I couldn't make up. I didn't know it. She said, Pastor, you know Sunday is my birthday. You will no longer call her Kizzy. Everybody say, hey, Elder Beloved. Come here, Elder Beloved. She is single. If you like her, you must get my permission. Lady Vernon, are her managers. Praise God. Amen. But you talk about a wonderful, if you got enough Jesus and enough job, see me. Praise God. But she's a beautiful woman of God. Amen. Come on, would y'all clap for her? Let's bring them. Do me a favor. Would all current elders come to the stage very fast? Would y'all step all the way up to me, right, please? Step right there. All current elders, come stand behind them. Coming from every place. All current elders. 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 I'm doing something. Do me a favor. Just for 1 minute. All current elders, stand in front for just a moment of the elders we're getting ready to promote. All current elders, come up front, come fast, come fast. Just step up, all for our elders, come fast, come fast. Stand across from each other, just like that's perfect. Take a look at the stage. Yeah, this is a business day, so those watching, there's some Sundays I got to be the pastor. I can't worry about clicks and likes and hearts. So if you're watching from across the world, God's gonna spread it out. Spread it out. I want to see everybody. Spread it out. All the way down. All the way down. All the way down. Spread it. Spread it. Spread it. Spread it. Spread it. Spread it. I want you to look at the stage. I want you to look at the stage. Look at the stage. Look at the stage. Look at the stage, everybody. Everybody. If they're not standing on this stage right now, they're no longer elders here. Some of them may still go here, but they asked me, could they step away for business, for grandchildren, for life? Some fell away. I don't have to get into all that. But if you don't see them on the stage, don't call them elder. Call them brother when you see them. I don't care who it is. Look carefully now. If you make a mistake and call them elder, they'll correct you and say, my name is brother. My name is sister. These are the current elders of the Word Church that are served. Would y'all clap for them, maybe? As you can see, everybody is around my age or a bit older. I'm wondering in 2 years, will there be some people up here 30 and very early 40s that I can trust to handle people's secrets, to help me judge people? Do we sit them down? Do we give them 30 days? He messing with a bunch of girls in the choir. Do we put him out, literally? Is he running around lying to girls and security has to keep him out? What y'all think we should do? Is he dangerous? She's pregnant, first time, how do we love her? Such and such gay, spouse don't know. They're not ready for their spouse to know. Can you hold that? Or would you go home and tell the wrong person and then I have to almost embarrass you publicly because you broke somebody's trust? Y'all see the heaviness of this task? Here's my definition, then I'm gonna lay hands on them. Elder means you help me pastor. They will walk up to you and say, listen, baby, I love you, how you doing? If you see them and don't see me, can I talk to you? Who should you talk to? The one that kind of looks like you? Why not go to the female elders if you have a sexual issue? If you're figuring out something about a husband, why not go to a female elder? Older gentlemen in your 50s, 60s, there's some seasoned men that have lived, grandkids. I so thank God for Elder Ford, Elder Mackley, Elder Weeks, the fathers, and right now, including Brother Campbell, these are, would y'all clap, the fathers of this church. Come on, come on. Would y'all step back, please? Would y'all please bring the pillows out? Thank y'all for y'all time. I'm gonna do this and then we're gonna walk out together. Would y'all bring the pillows quickly, quickly as you can. Bring the pillows and put them in front of each elder. Bring the pillows and put them in front of each elder, please. Each elder elect, come fast as you can. Thank you. Put the pillows in front of each elder. Praise God, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Put a pillow really quickly in front of each elder, thank you. We normally would use a kneeler, but it's too many of them. So we went and got some pillows so that they could honor. We're going to play it off and use these pillows for decoration someplace. Amen. Amen. We ain't throwing them away. Believe that. Amen. I want y'all to do me a favor. Would y'all now stand? When I lay my hands on them, come on over here with me, baby. Come on. They are official. Would all of you please kneel? Hey, Kerabashi, say Kerabashi. Would you please kneel? Please kneel. 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 Lady Vernon, come over here with me. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. As I lay my hands on them, would you just stretch your hand? These are the elders of the Word Church. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I ordain you to the office of elder. In the name of Jesus, as a couple, you shall serve together. I speak leadership over your house as you serve. Ooh, that's all right, baby. In the name of Jesus. I lay my hands on you. Ooh, in the name of Jesus, I lay my hands on you now. In the name of Jesus, I lay. In the name of Jesus. Come on, brother. In the name of Jesus, 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 in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for all of them. Now, God, bless each one of them as we stretch our hand toward them as a congregation. We pray blessings on them. Father, thank you for what you're doing. Father, we pray now that you bless each one of them. Have your way in their life. Thank you that you are using them, God, in a way that you never have before. Bless each one of them, Father. We pray covering over their lives. And every attack of the enemy shall be quelled now. And Father, as the enemy comes with them, we pray spiritual warfare over them. Father, we pray that you'll give them wisdom. Father, we pray that you'll give them love. We pray that you'll give them all that they need to serve these your people. Now, Father, we lay our hands on them in the spirit realm. We ordain and call them to a new level of spiritual authority in the Word Church. Father, bless them now. Have your way in their life. Father, we thank you that it's already done. Now, God, I got a special favor. Bless their children. Bless their grandchildren. Bless their spouses who may not be on the stage, that there will not be any tension in their house, that the enemy will not be able to come in there, Father, and touch what God is doing. Father, we pray blessings on all of them now, and it is so. In Jesus' name, amen. Oh, you can stand. It amas. Please don't walk. I gotta say this right quick. I'ma say it and then we're gonna walk out together. Ladies and gentlemen, I now give you the elders of the Word Church. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
Want to miss an interview, a powerful worship song, a special event, or an incredible word from our man and woman of God, Drs. R.A. and Victory Vernon, then be sure to subscribe to the official YouTube channel of The Word Church. Just click the subscribe button and ring the notification bell so that you never miss an upload.